Now that you've learned how to pause and continue your app, let's learn a little more about how to control breakpoints.
In the previous video, you just set one breakpoint in init. There must be something different about the two checklist items that are getting checked and the one checklist item that isn't getting checked. In the next video, you'll learn how to inspect the state of your application while it's paused. But for now, just add a couple of breakpoints where the other two items are created, on lines 110 and 115. Then add one where the created items are being used in table view, self arrow at index path, on line 170. Now build and run. Now you see execution pauses at the first breakpoint. This time, when you click continue, execution pauses at the second breakpoint. Continue basically says, continue running until you hit another breakpoint, and then pause again. If no other breakpoint is hit, execution continues normally, but if one is hit, execution pauses there. This lets you pause at different points in your app where you want to see what's happening under the hood. Click continue again, and the third breakpoint in the init method is hit. Now, click it one more time. At this point, execution is out of the init method and has stopped in self arrow at index path. This is where the items created in init are being used. Now, if you click continue several times, Xcode just kind of flashes, and the green line stays on our breakpoint. No, this breakpoint didn't break Xcode. It's just that this method is called once for each cell in the table view, and you have 8, so it will get called 8 times. This brings up an issue with breakpoints. Sometimes you want a breakpoint to exist because you're going to use it later, but you don't want execution to stop there right now. You can delete a breakpoint, and we'll take a look at that in just a minute. But in this case, you just want to disable the breakpoint. The easiest way to disable one breakpoint is to click on its indicator. As you can see, each time we click on it, the breakpoint toggles between enabled and disabled. A disabled breakpoint is shown by the indicator turning pale blue. Okay, leave this one disabled and continue. Now, execution continues normally because no other enabled breakpoint is hit. Disabling individual breakpoints is great, but what if you want to disable all breakpoints and just run normally? Do you have to find all breakpoints and disable them one by one? Nope, this button will let you deactivate all breakpoints. Leave this enabled for now and build and run again. Once again, if your app is still running, click stop to continue. This isn't because it's backwards day and stop means go. You're telling Xcode to stop the previous run in order to continue this one. Now that execution is stopped at the first breakpoint, click on the button to deactivate all breakpoints. If you open the breakpoint navigator, you can see that the breakpoint indicators all turn gray. Fortunately, Xcode will even save the breakpoint's enabled or disabled state so that when you click it again, the breakpoints reactivate to their last state. Let's leave the breakpoints deactivated and click continue. You can see that execution continues normally. None of the breakpoints are being hit. There is one other way to control breakpoints, and that's by deleting them. You would usually disable a breakpoint if you plan to use it again, but if you're done with a breakpoint, you can just delete it. If you drag the breakpoint indicator up and down, it will move to that new location. But if you drag to the right until the X indicator shows up, the breakpoint will be deleted. You can also select breakpoint in the navigator and press delete. This is a quick way to clean up multiple breakpoints that you no longer need.
Being a good developer means being a good debugger. And what better place to learn about debugging than at this channel? So hit that subscribe button and keep checking back for more videos on debugging iOS apps.